Now what happened is the angels crossed a boundary that they should not have crossed. And they went to lay with who? Come on, I need participation today. They lay with the daughters of men and they produced what?
Giants.
They had babies. And the Bible, the King James Version, says that these babies was renowned. Do anybody know what it means to be renowned? It means to be famous. Oh, somebody gonna catch this in a minute. They was renowned that they had great influence. They were flamed, they was known in the earth. Watch this. And it also says that they were old. Well, wait a minute. When a baby comes out, a baby is what? Brand new, young. So why did it say that they were old? Because the spirit on the inside of them was ancient. Somebody better get this. The spirit on the inside of that baby, on that womb, was ancient. Hallelujah. And what happened is you got to watch this. Who told you was naked? Because you didn't know before. Oh, somebody better get this in the book of Genesis.
Come on.
Adam and Eve. First of all, you've been walking around like this since I created you. Amen. I've been providing for you all this time. But somebody done came and influenced you and told you you was naked. Who was it? Amen. Because you didn't know that. And I see, amen, hallelujah, that you're covering the places where you sin. The Bible says they covered themselves with fig leaves. And the areas where they sinned. Somebody ought to call it right there. Amen. Hallelujah. So you didn't cover up your arm. Praise God. You didn't cover up your ankle. Somebody going to get this in a minute. Amen. You didn't cover your neck up. No, you didn't do that. Amen. You covered the areas where you had sinned. Somebody ought to catch it in the spirit.
Sexually.
Oh, come on. Come on, Papa. Amen. Hallelujah. That's where you cover. So you sit there. And as soon as you sit, it took you out of the covenant of God. Somebody better catch this. Took you out of the covenant of God. Amen. And people would teach that Adam and Eve was cursed. They wasn't cursed. They was disciplined. But there was somebody that was cursed. Oh, somebody, go back and read it for yourself. He didn't curse his creation. He disciplined them. And he disciplined them. And when he disciplined them, hallelujah, that means he put them out. It seems like the Father love to put you out if you don't act right now. We don't see two illustrations. He don't put them out of heaven. Now he put them out of the garden. Amen. I ain't dealing with it. Amen. Praise God. Put them out. He put them out. Hallelujah. And he told them, hey, this is your discipline. Since you want to disobey me, you're going to work. You're going to work for this woman. And you're going to till the ground. Hallelujah. And for you doing that, you're going to have conception. If you read the scriptures, it says that woman was given conception. People think that that's having baby. No, conception means that, you know, we say it all the time. I don't like to say this, but we say it all the time. When you have conception, that means that you have a lot of intellect. You're very smart. You're very clever. Amen. Hallelujah. That's why, can I be transparent? We're gonna get out of here. Oh, I'm just trying so carefully to, my words. You know, somehow I get sometimes. Praise God. Amen. That means, amen, a man don't know when he's being cracked on. Can I speak like this? Or y'all gonna get mad? Men don't have no idea. Woman could be flirting with them. They be like, oh, do. They have no idea. But you know, what did you see that? What? See what, baby? What's that? I ain't seen that. What? And they dancing. That's it. Oh, I know you. I know you see. No, really, I didn't though. No. Watch this. A woman can take five different things and do it at the same time. But man have trouble doing one or two. It's not bad. Because guess what? We were created to be helpmates. That means we were created to assist you, not overtake you. Oh, somebody better catch this. And that's why God gave us the ability to do multiple things. But see, we got our purpose twisted.
Come on.
Somebody better catch this. Amen. Hallelujah. And what happened? Amen. Hallelujah. Can I go ahead with y'all? Amen. Usually I can't give people meat. They spit it back up. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. What happened? Amen. Hallelujah. Is that amen, woman was created to be the helpmate. Hallelujah. And God told us that it was good for man not to be alone. Can I give you this meat? Or some of you going to regurgitate it back up. Said it wasn't good for man to be alone. So what he did was created the solution. And the solution was woman. Why wasn't it a horse? Why wasn't it a bird? Why wasn't it, amen, some tablets with some commandments on it? Why was the solution woman? Oh, come on. Somebody gonna catch this. Said it wasn't good for man to be alone. Can I speak to you transparent? Now, I know we might have some people out there, amen, that disagree with me, but I'm gonna teach this because y'all letting me. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, Holy Ghost. Now, here it is. Adam is out there naming all the cattle. Male and female. Mm-hmm. Now, male and female is having some babies and they mate. Can I? Mm-hmm. Y'all gonna let me teach this?
Come
on. Can I teach it? They mating. Wait a minute. That cow is mating with that bull. Amen. Hallelujah. And Lord, look at the pigs. Oh my goodness, look over here at the bird. All of them are mating. Who's mine? It's not good for man to be alone. Can I teach like this?
Yes.
It's not good for man to be alone. So man had to be doing something that was unseen. Oh, can we accept? Oh, come on. Man had to be doing something that God said that I'm going to have to create a helpmate for him. Amen. Because I see he don't do good by himself. Amen. It's just all right. I see that he don't do good by himself, so I got to create him a helpmate, amen, and the helpmate is going to be woman, amen, but listen, because you didn't listen to me in the beginning, you didn't begin to fulfill your purpose, I'm going to have to punish you, amen, I'm going to have to discipline you, because you have stepped over some boundaries.
Come on.
Somebody better get this.
All right, now.
So women have the ability to do five different things. We have the ability to provoke. Did you know that woman?
Yes.
Oh, you can provoke the worst of the worst. Mm-hmm. But you can turn that thing around and use it for good, too. Because you can provoke people to get up off their feet and do something about their situation.
Amen.
That's the natural authority on the inside of you. Mm-hmm. We provoke. Listen, let me tell you something. We weren't in the real, original plan, woman. And you say, what you say, Pastor? Yes, we was not in the original plan. It was not in the original plan. It was because of man that God created us. He said it wasn't good for man to be alone. So let me create him a helpmate. You wasn't in the plan, woman.
That's right.
So if you ain't going to do nothing, amen, be grateful that they did what they did so we could be created.
Amen.
Is this all right?
Amen.
The Lord's going to wrap it up. Amen. Hallelujah. Because I told you this was a session. So here it is. Amen. He created us. And he began to punish us because of the Garden of Eve, and he increased our conception. Go read it. It's in the Bible. So that means that we can do multiple things at one time. Amen. That means that when a vision comes, we already working out the plan. Oh, somebody just doing like, yes, Pastor, I'm trying to tell him that if he does this, and we can do this, and we can do that, and we can put this here automatically. And we get it confused and think that woman is a Jezebel. No, that woman has the ability to create plans. That woman has the ability, amen, hallelujah, that if you give her an idea, she gonna run with it. You taking over my? No, I'm not taking over. I'm just saying that if you do this and do that, you can such and such, such and such. That is our natural. We will push our brothers. We will push our husbands. We will push our uncles, our sons. We will push them and we will give them visions. It's not that we are overtaking them. It's that that's who we was built to be. But where there is no vision, we gonna get agitated and we gonna get upset, and you ain't such a, you ain't doing nothing with your life, and you ain't such a, because we need something to follow. So what happens, man, your original purpose is to give us a vision. You the king.
That's right.
Hallelujah. You give us a fuck. You tell me, amen, hallelujah. Listen. Amen. My daddy said, will you calm it down, Sam? Because she's back there all in my head. Man has a vision. He always had. When God created man, he gave him the occupation and we learned this from Miles Monroe, people. God, he gave him an occupation, gave him a job first. It wasn't woman.
That's right.
Come on.
It was a job. It was an occupation. It was a purpose. He gave him purpose first. He had to name all the animals.
Yes, Lord.
And that was his job. But God created a helpmate, and he didn't want to use her.
Mm.
He didn't want to use her. So he left her in the garden.
Mm.
Left her unattended. Mm. And when she was unattended,
come on,
amen, He come.
You gotta say it. Come on.
The devil, I love this Pastor Dave, you say it all the time. The devil is an opportunist.
That's right.
He looks for opportunity. Mm-hmm. Left for by ourselves.
That's right.
And some of us, amen, we leaving our children by themselves.
Come on.
Can I talk like this?
Come on.
We leaving our loved ones by themselves.
Come on.
Amen. And they're being preoccupied by something that God don't want them to be in.
Yes, Lord.
Watch this.
Yes.
Oh, we getting there. I told you it's going to be a teacher.
Ouch.
So what happened?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Eve out there in the garden. Y'all got to know Eve was a beautiful woman. Y'all got to know that, right?
Yes.
Y'all got to know she was fine. Because the reason why I'm saying y'all got to know that she was very attractive is because Adam said this. He said, flesh of my flesh, bone of my
bone.
He didn't say, what is it, Sister Jenny? Look, Sister Jenny May talked this real good. He didn't say, soul of my soul. He didn't say, woman of wisdom. He said, flesh of my flesh, bone of my bone. I shall call you woman. Because you was made from a man. That's what he said. So we get mad when men are attracted to us on the outside. That's their natural. That's their natural.
Come on.
Oh, somebody don't. Oh, do anybody teach like this? Anybody want to hear this?
Yes.
So we get mad because the man is attracted to your outside. That's his nature.
Yes.
But your nature is to make sure he gets what he needs. Amen? And when I say gets what he needs, I mean to assist him in truth. He gonna be attracted to your outside for us. Daddy said, talk about it, baby. He gonna be attracted to your outside. That's all a man just such and such, such and such. But it is your job to convince him of the truth.
Amen.
You said, Pastor, this is unheard of. Well, I'm teaching you the truth. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Now watch this. I'm almost there. I told you it's about seven teachers. Watch this, people. In the book of Genesis, amen, when the Lord was disciplining them, this is what he said. He said this. He said, why did you go out there? Y'all want this meat?
Come on.
Ooh, I don't think. I'm hesitant about giving this meat. Because some people can't take this, y'all.
We didn't do it, girl.
Here we go. Hey, Lord, meat. Now, I cut some up for you, but you're going to have to take this whole thing and chew it, okay?
Yeah.
Amen? Here we go. This is what God said to Adam first. He said, you don't sin. This is what he said to Adam. He said, why you did this? I'm saying, the woman you gave me. You gave it to me. You the one said it was good for me to be alone. You the one said, amen, hallelujah, that you was creating the fault. Now look what she done did. Let me tell you something. And guys, this is not to belittle any creation. It's to make you understand the creation. Amen, hallelujah. The man made an excuse. So what happens is we get mad at men and women when they make excuses. Well, it's all right. Look at me, Chris said, I don't want to hear it.
I don't.
We get mad when the man makes an excuse about his situation, his circumstance. We get mad when the brother, the uncle, the husband, all these people make excuses about when they do wrong. But look what Eve did. Look what the woman did. He said, why you do this, daughter? She said, the serpent beguiled me and I did eat. See any excuses? You see, she just said, I messed up.
Yeah.
It is very easy for women to confess.
And
somebody better catch this. It's very easy. It's not that it's not easy for men to confess. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. But it's very easy for women to confess. And we said, yeah, daddy, he tricked me. She said, I did eat. Right? Mm-hmm. So daddy got mad. And offer her answer. This is why I say we're provokers. Our father was provoked. He said, serpent, because you have done this. He said, you will eat from the ground all the days of your life. Because you sit and belittle my daughter. Oh, somebody better catch this in the spirit. We're provokers. And see, sometimes we use our authority and our powers the wrong way. We provoke people to do wrong instead of right.
Yes.
Hallelujah. But if we can shift that down. He said, you will eat from the dust of the ground all the days of your life. That's what's going to happen. You're going to eat from the dust of the ground, and you're going to be... What we don't know is that Lucifer used to walk the earth, but God cursed him, and he went to a lower.
Mm-hmm.
You ever been low, and then you went even low?
Mm-hmm.
That was a deep low, right? Mm-hmm. Went to another low. Watch this, people, God. So after that happened, amen, we back at the ark. We finna wrap it up. We back at the ark. And the Lord says, I'm finna destroy man because of this. They have given to their own lust. And watch this. What the scripture is saying, King James said that they gave themselves over to strange flesh. They gave themselves over to fornication. They gave themselves over to alternative lifestyles. They gave themselves over to lies. They gave themselves over to pride. They gave themselves over to all these different things. He said the wickedness was great. He repented that he made his image. Isn't that something? Y'all know what that's like? That's like you rejecting your womb. It's like me rejecting that I have a son and daughter. I repented that I even brought him into earth. Somebody ought to count that. I repented that I even brought them in the earth. I repented that I even brought them in the earth. He said, I repented because I made them. He said, now I want you to build me the ark because you're the only one in your generation that's righteous. Somebody ought to catch this in the spirit. You're the only one in your generation. You mean of all the people that was on earth, he only found one man that was righteous? You mean all the people that's on this earth right now, we can only find a few that is righteous? He said, I'm gonna wipe them all out. He said, in 7 days, I'm gonna erase the entire, all flesh. He said, beast, man, woman, all flesh shall cease to exist. If the scripture says that I'm gonna take the breath that I put in them and I'm gonna remove it up out of them. I'm wiping out the whole earth. Somebody better catch this in the spirit. I'm gonna get you. Somebody catch this in the spirit. That he's gonna wipe the whole earth because of the stuff we doing. So he said, build the ark. He said, I want you to put seven. This is why you gotta read the word. The reason we error because we don't read the word. Some of us think he put two things in the boat. No, he didn't. He said, I want you to put seven clean animals in the boat, and I want you to put two unclean animals in the boat. Now, you got to ask yourself, why do you want seven clean things and two unclean things? And this is what he said. He said, I want you to put them in the boat by male and female. Everything he said, male and female, put them in there by male and female. Read the scriptures for yourself, Genesis 6, whole chapter and 7. Male and female. And he said this. He said, I want you to put them like that so they can multiply.
Amen.
Somebody better catch this. I want them in there so they can multiply. Yes. And he began to put seven clean things and two bad things. I said, well, God, if you wanted to get rid of the bad, why you put bad things in the ark? He said, because it's a balance. You won't know what is good unless you understand that. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Somebody else, you wouldn't even know what happiness was if you didn't experience sad. You wouldn't even know what it means to be rich if you didn't experience being poor. Amen. It is a balance. And what we don't want to deal with is the balance of life. Amen. We don't want to deal with, there's going to be some days that I'm happy and there's going to be some days that I'm not. Amen. We don't want to deal with, there's going to be some days that I'm overtaken by sin and there's going to be some days that I'm not. We don't want to deal with the balance. Somebody better catch this. And if we were able to deal with the balance, we could get farther with this walk with God.
Yeah,
wow. It was a balance. Last thing. And we'll continue the series. Amen. Later on. This is what he said. He said, I want you to build me an ark because I'm going to wipe off all flesh. 7 days. Amen. I'm going to make it rain for 40 days and 40 nights. People, God. And sometimes we want to bring logic and scientific notions. I'll give you your logic and your scientific notions. How much body of water is on the earth? How much body of water is on earth? Whole lot of it, ain't it? Whole lot of body of water. So if you want to go to your scientific notions, amen. Lot of water. That's about 40 days. About 40 days of water. About 40 nights of water. Amen. Hallelujah. More water on the earth than it is. Amen. Now watch this. It says, I'm going to kill all flesh. But what we got to understand is angels don't die.
Amen.
Spirits don't die. Demons don't die. You can put them in bondage. You can send them back with the authority of Jesus Christ, but they don't die.
Amen.
So guess what they're doing? That's what they're doing. It says that Lucifer led a third of the angels out of heaven with his tail, meaning influence. He got a mean dime piece. Hallelujah. He can talk you into doing anything. You think because I'm a pastor I can't fall? Please, I don't trust my flesh.
Amen.
I trust God to keep me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Anything you can name, I probably don't did it. Praise him.
Amen.
But the only reason I stand in my boundaries is because of him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
I want to end it with this, people, God. Noah built the ark. And as he built this ark, amen, I want you to imagine. I want you to imagine people mocking him and picking at him because it never rained on the earth. I can see people saying, look at this fool. Look at, girl, he done went and got some gopher wood. Look at, and he got his children out there. They painting it and everything. Look at them. They, what, and this is ridiculous. Look at him. I can see little bad children throwing rocks at the ark. You understand what I'm saying? I can see all kind of stuff in the spirit. Look at you. I can see him cussing at Noah. You's a idiot. You's a fool. And I can see Noah still working. Still being obedient. And I can see his children. Daddy, why we got to do this? Father, this don't even sound right. But I see his children because they know that God is in them, that they submit themselves to him. And I can see, amen, hallelujah, and they're like, girl, they putting animals. Do you see this boy? They got animals and they putting them on the boat. This is ridiculous. Somebody need to, I'm going to go get Sue down the street and I'm going to show them. Look at all this mess. Girl, they got giraffes. Everything is on the boat. Look at this mess. Oh, Lord, how much. And I can see them still drinking. Somebody better catch this in the spirit. Still partying, still doing, still fulfilling the lust of their flesh, still doing everything while he's steady building this symbol that is all about the end. We got all this calamity on us and we still concerned with our flesh. We got all this stuff going on in the earth and we still concerned with our flesh. And I can see as the first drop fall. I can see as the drizzles come. Remember, it never rained. And I could see them like, what is this coming from? I could see them looking like, what is this? Oh, somebody better catch this imagery real well.
Come on, come on. Mm-hmm.
What in the world is this? What is this? This wetness? What in the world? And I could see them remembering the crazy one that you call crazy, amen? The one that you said didn't know what they was talking about. The one that you said, that woman always talking about some spirit and some invisible kingdom. She don't know what she's talking about. I could see the one that you call crazy, amen? I could see you running back to that person right there, amen? Because calamity has reached your door, amen? Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I could see them running to the ship. I could see them, amen? Hallelujah. Amen. Running and calling. And I could see... I can see Noah in tears. I gotta shut the door on my friends. I gotta shut the door on my loved ones. I gotta shut the door on little kids that's been at over to eat at my home. I gotta shut the door on these babies. And I can see him shutting the door and I can hear. Because I don't believe that they even had the strength to watch people drown and die. But I can just imagine the screams and the begging. Please let us in. Do you know that's the way the end is going to be?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody need to catch this in the spirit. I ain't trying to scare you. I'm trying to wake you up.
Amen.
So here it was, people of God. Hallelujah. He built the ship. 40 days, 40 nights. Now, some people think he was just on the ship for 40 days, 40 nights. No, people, God, it's called evaporation. The water got to go down, amen, hallelujah, and some land got to be revealed, amen, hallelujah. Amen, that took some time. I think it was about 160, 150, I can't remember exactly. But, hallelujah, they finally got to a place of dry land, amen, and they finally got through this place of dry land. And we're going to start right there at the place of dry land. But what the Lord is trying to teach you, people, God, is somebody taught you these behaviors. Somebody taught us how to sin. And you think it was your daddy. You think it was your mama. You think it was yourself. Mm-mm. It was the fallen angels. Greetings, beloved. My name is Pastor Sharon L. Fields. I pastor Father's Vision Ministry. We would love to have you come out and fellowship with us. We believe that this is a spirit-filled place. We believe that the Holy Ghost speaks through us to empower you. Come on, come and fellowship with us and get the word that you need today in order to have those principles in your life.